Hello friends, welcome to Veena's Educate. How many of you think biology is a subject to be learned and aspired only by those who want to become a doctor, who want to become a scientist, or who want to take up BioPC as a subject? If I ask you, you may say yes, but I say it is to be learned and understood by everybody and anybody. In fact, as you are growing older and older, you are prone to many health issues, for which you start surfing the internet, start surfing books, and then you try to find solutions for your health problems. What if you have the basic knowledge of your human body and the environment around you so that you can avoid certain basic health threats and find solutions for yourself? The textbooks of class 10 gives this basic knowledge about the human body. So let us begin with it. Here you can see this is a ball, this is a stone, this is a marble, and then you can see these are plants. You can see myself, the human body. All these are made up of the same basic elements, that is carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen. Now, if I throw this stone into the air, it will come down. If I jump, I will land down. Because we are all subjected to the same physical laws like gravitation, magnetism, and radiation, etc. Then, what marks the difference between these? These are having life. They can breathe. They require food for their growth. These, they do not require any food. They do not grow. These do not have life. So, these are said to be the living things, and these are said to be the non-living things. What marks the difference between these living things, non-living things is they have life and these do not have life. Now, all the unicellular organisms and up to the multicellular organisms, they perform certain functions to maintain their life. So all these processes put together, which perform the maintenance job and are very much needed for sustaining of the life, are called as life processes. Now, the various life processes are nutrition, respiration, excretion, transportation, control and coordination, and reproduction. In the next video, we shall learn about these life processes one by one. So keep watching, keep learning. Thank you, friends.